morning out there. Actually, guys, it's almost 1 o'clock. And I just wanted to add this to my last video, which is on, which I've been working on since yesterday. Okay. If you like videos like this, you know, like, subscribe, share. Also, you can also help support this channel by checking the links down below. You can get shirts and stickers and just contribute any way you want, really. I do have something, I do have a crowdfunding website, kind of like just like Patreon, but it's not Patreon. This one charges less fees. Okay, so that's all Patreon is. People ask me about that. Why don't you get a Patreon account? Well, there's some issues with Patreon. I don't need to go into, but... But anyway, we're gonna, I wanna get my welder out. I don't know whether this is gonna happen today, but finish up this bumper. I got a little work to do on the radius arm on the other side. But what's holding me up right now, which is kinda like, oh geez, why couldn't it be something easy? I'm trying to get this back door open. Window goes up and down, but it's not releasing. The lever back here isn't doing it that. So it looks like it'd be easy to just take the panel off here to access the parts and see what's binding up or holding up or anything, but my drawers are in the way, my slider back here. You know, I put that in probably 10 years ago. I'm trying to think, well, how does this thing come out of here? So, that's what them holes are for. See them holes there? Those are to access the brackets underneath. What you do is you slide it forward and then you unbolt the brackets and it'll come out. Yeah, I can't get it to slide forward because the door's in the way. Stupid dogs. What the hell? What the hell, man? I know somebody is asking out there, how did I make those drawer sliders or make this drawer? Well, here's a good look now that I got it all tore up. Wow, no wonder why this side was so hard to cut. Good old Milwaukee tools.
It's Saturday.
These are the brackets. They're just drawer sliders you buy at a freaking hardware store. They're rated at 100 pounds per pair. So, yeah. Yeah, 100 pounds per pair. So I got one set here, one set here, and one set there. And then to attach them, I use this angle. You can buy this there at the hardware store, you know. Brackets with the holes in them. Shoot, boy. But anyway, And then this I made all cut and glued together. What's that, MDF board? Here's the other half. See, I couldn't get this panel off because I couldn't access the screws on the bottom with this end on here. This, yeah, it's supposed to go like that, right? Something like that. Got it done in a bed liner. Oh well. I guess I could fit it back up. There's a way, but for right now, yeah. So anyway, so everything is bolted together and then screwed, set in place, and then screwed down to the steel. See the screws here? The screw fender washers, screw and fender washers. And yeah, so the access holes for the screws are right here. See, you slide it through as you loosen the screws up or tighten them up, and there you have it. But in order to remove it, you're gonna have to slide the thing open, and you can't open it unless the door is open. So kind of worked. Actually, it's done a very good job. Put all my camping stuff on here when I go off-roading and slide everything out. Got little tie downs on here. So yeah, so this thing here pulls a rod that hits this piece here that pushes that one over. See that? It's not pushing it over enough. Why? Because it's bent. Just like he told me, who was that? Big Bob Woolly Woody or Big Woody Bob or something like that. Let's see if I can get in there with this camera. Let's see. Ow! Everything's getting hot out here. Now, I could take the four bolts out here, the three bolts out here, and probably take the whole thing out, but like I said, this is not no how-to video. I mean, this is taking long enough as it is, but I showed you what the problem is. I showed you the basics, and I really didn't want to pull the whole mechanism out of there because these little plastic things, I break them every time, but you know what, another thing, it's hot out here, so everything back here is hot, and I'm trying to lean over on things, my arms are burning out. But anyway, I got it out, and once I figured it out, you know, you gotta know how to take these things off. Okay? Looks complicated. Oh yeah, how do you take that off without breaking them? Well, first of all, they're in the hole there. See, they're in the hole. So you can't push them back out without breaking them, but you don't need to push them out. I was thinking I had to push them out. What you do is unhook the rod. See the rod here? This is the rod off the door handle. This is the piece that's bent. And that's another thing. I gotta straighten that out, but it's also cracking. Where you can see the crack in there, I can't see on the screen here, but where's that? I saw a crack in there somewhere. Yeah, there's a crack in there. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see it on this camera here. There's a crack. So when I bend it, it's probably gonna crack more, right? So I'm gonna try to straighten it out and then get my welder out and put a couple tacks on there. My little welder, not the big 220 welder. See if I can get it to work. But anyway, see these things? The rod is clipped into the plastic thing. That's all you gotta remove, so. See that? Swing it out of there, and then the rod just comes right out. See, I thought these things were locked in there. So now, what locks them in is this piece. Once the rod's snapped in there, then it's not going nowhere, so. Hopefully I can remember how everything goes back together, but now I gotta see if I can straighten that out. That's another thing. But if you look, okay, so one rod connects to one side of the door on this one, and the other rod connects on this side of the door. And when you pull the handle, okay, it moves like that, right? It pulls one side and pulls the other side. Okay, the handle is hooked up to this one right here that's bent. And so when this moves, it pushes right here, right? And it pushes everything. But you know what, look at this. It's not gonna move anywhere because it's locked in with this one right here. This has to go out of the way first. And then everything will push free, right? So let me see if I can do this. Yeah. Okay, so this is the handle. You pull the handle, it's a little tough. Yes. But yeah. This here isn't hooked up to anything. This is like an interlock, I guess, so you can't open it. Because you're pulling on this, and this little tab is in the way. It's blocking it from moving. No wonder why it's all bent. So I got to find out what the heck this goes to, because there was nothing on it. If anything, it should be in the back of the door there somewhere. There it is. So anyway, I was able to hammer this out, straighten it up, put a little weld on there. Now, I wanted to use my 110 welder, but I haven't used that in such a long time that I didn't know it didn't have any wire in it. So the 220 welder's all set up, but man, that thing will burn. That thing's hot. I got a good suntan on that thing. Last time I used it, I didn't realize it until I was done the next day. I was like, man, my arms are all red. How come? But yeah, I just wanted to put a nice booger weld in there where we're at, right there, where that crack was. It almost burned through. You gotta be real careful welding this small stuff, especially with that big welder. I had the settings down, but anyway, everything works now. And I just gotta put it back together. If I can find that piece. All right, guys, I got it. It works. It actually works. So, I don't know what I'm gonna do about the slider, but for right now, I could piece it back together. I could dowel it and glue it back together. I mean, this piece here is actually in three pieces. And I doweled it and glued it and screwed it, and it's held up all these years. But when I cut this, I cut through these brackets here too. So it's like, oh man. For right now, the important thing, the door works now. See how that works? This pulls, that pulls those. There's another one right here for that side. And that third rod that was disconnected goes back there. And all that does there is sit there. And the end has got a bend on it like that, a 90 degree bend looking down. So when you roll the window down, it pulls the rod. So you can open the door. I must have left that off when I did the regulator or something, I don't know. I should be able to do that like that. You pull on it too hard, you're gonna bend everything. But my goodness, see, this is learn as you go stuff. Make sure you open these first. Yep, nice and easy. Yeah, you're not supposed to be able to open the door without the window being down, because you're not gonna open the door anyway because the glass is locked in up here, right? So anyway, this is the latest project right here. And I'm upgrading this. My plan is to upgrade the struts with some conies. Of course, they don't make these for the coney for this truck, for these Colorados. Now they make them for the Isuzu D-Max, but they, you know, they don't sell them here. So I had to order them from Germany, so they're on their way. The American Colorado and the Isuzu D-Max share the same platform, so there's parts that are interchangeable on these things. Some parts, not all the parts, you know. So I'm working on that right now. So if I can get some conies out here, I gotta fit them up. My problem is I threw away the factory springs, but the factory springs are kind of soft, so I'd like to upgrade them springs, and I can't find any information on springs, right? Like, what is the load rating and what is the length spring? I don't need lift springs. There's lift springs out there. Go to Eibach. Eibach sells them. Old Man Emu sells them, but I don't need lift springs. I already got a lift down there. So that's my issue. I got some ideas going on right now up in my head, and I got an opportunity for some springs at a really good price. Like, I think I'm, if you go to the Chevy website, go to Chevy Performance. Chevy Performance has the long travel Multimatic shocks, and they recommend upgrading the springs. So they give you two suggestions there, a 650 spring or a 700 pound spring. Okay, to fit those shocks, those longer shocks, the long traveled Multimatics. I go, okay, that gives me a good starting point, so I'm gonna go with some 650 springs on the front, only because the place I'm getting from don't have 700 pounders. I mean, they do, but not at the price, right? So anyway, that's what I'm doing. That's what I'm doing. Now I need the length. How long? So I'm working on that. So anybody knows the length of a factory Colorado spring? That, and I don't mean on the truck, I mean off the truck. A loose spring. Ow. Oh, God. Yeah, like this, see? Out of the truck. Free, it's called free length or something like that. I need to know that number. So anyway, my conies are coming from Germany. I just got an email the other day in German that they're on their way, so. And then I'm gonna have some fitted for the back. I'm gonna get together with Coney USA and we'll get you a part number. So if you wanted to go this way, maybe we'll set it up, you know, with some longer coils and all that, so it'll be like a Coney lift kit. Alright, so besides that, yeah, this is what it is. So if you like these videos, if you like trail runs and repairs and modifications, this is not fancy stuff. I don't do all those bling stuff like changing the grills out and changing the lights out just because, you know, putting LEDs because everybody thinks they're cool. Switchback lights and all that stuff. Basic stuff to go hit the trails, that's what I do. Yeah, I mean, it was a long time before I got a LED bar. People tell, when do you get a light bar? When do you get a light bar? When do you get a light bar? I got them, they're all right, but I'm not impressed. I like my HID lights better. Even those are better. KC LEDs. I could have spent more money on those too. KC sells, six of them to go on there for about $1,000, but heck, I don't need to spend $1,000 to hit the trails, right? I need things that work. I need a spring from here to there. It's got to have this thing on it. Oh, my God. that side. I need to pick and cut myself.